everyone, welcome to Brihan Mumbai Municipal Corporation's virtual training center, and I am Mrs. Nehal Kodambe, your English teacher from VTC. Let's begin with today's session.
Hi everyone, welcome to today's session. Dear children, as you know, when there is a vacation, we plan for going somewhere out. Out means some people plan to go to their native places, some plan to go to visit some historical places. As you know, in Maharashtra, we all stay in Maharashtra, there are so many forts, there are so many places where we wish to go, right? And why do we wish to go? Because as we have seen, since ancient times, people are fond of traveling. They like to go from one place to another place, though sometimes reasons are for education, sometimes for work, or sometimes it is only for entertainment. But still there are some people on the earth that they wish to know more about the earth, more about the nature, and so that they find out such places from on the earth and they do visit there. So in today's session, we are going to learn more about these places on the earth, not only in India, but all around the world. And we will try to know more about it, more about them. Okay, so today's topic is knowing more about the World Heritage. Now in today's session, we will try to know the meaning of World Heritage, the term of World Heritage, and then we will see how this idea or how this concept has born or it has taken birth here in this world. Okay, so let's begin with the lesson. So first of all, you have a look here. On this screen, you can see there are very famous places in India. There are Ajanta Caves from Maharashtra, then monuments at Hampi, then Humayun's Tomb, Sun Temple at Konark. Then you can see there Manas Wildlife Sanctuary's picture, Fatehpur Sikri, Khajuraho monuments, Buddhist monuments, then Mahabodhi Temple at Bihar, Agra Fort, very famous Red Fort or Agra Fort. Then you can see Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminus. We are so proud of it because this is Mumbai's pride. Nalanda University, and so many places are there in India where we find tourists from all over the world. They do come and they try to know more about the Indian culture. So why is it happens? What make a person or a man or a woman to know or to visit such places? So that's what we are going to learn in today's session, and we will learn more about these monuments or this architecture or these places, why they have so much importance, historical as well as geographical importance. First of all, before moving towards World Heritage, we will try to know the meaning of term heritage. What is heritage? So heritage is our legacy from the past. From the past, what we leave with today and what we pass on to future generations. Our cultural and natural heritage are both irreplaceable sources of life and inspiration. आजच्या पाठामध्ये आपण जे वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज बघणार आहोत त्यातला हेरिटेज जो शब्द आहे मराठीमध्ये आपण त्याला वारसा म्हणतो की जो मागच्या पिढीने आपल्याला दिलाय त्याच्याबरोबर आपण आज आहोत आणि आपण पुढच्या पिढीकडे तो सोपवणार आहोत. आता याच्यामध्ये सांस्कृतिक आणि नैसर्गिक असे दोन्ही प्रकार समाविष्ट केलेले आहेत, तेच आपण आजच्या भागामध्ये बघणार आहोत. दिस इज व्हेरी 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 मच इंटरेस्टिंग लेसन. especially for those children who are fond of visiting historical or geographical places, or those who keep interest in learning more about our legacy. So now we will try to know the meaning of term World Heritage. Just now we have seen the meaning of heritage. What is heritage? Varsa. Now World Heritage manje kay? Jagatik varsa. Now what is World Heritage? First try to know that. So World Heritage is the designation for places on earth. We are talking about the globe. On earth that are of outstanding universal value to humanity and as such have been inscribed on the World Heritage List to be protected for future generation to appreciate and enjoy. So what is World Heritage? So World Heritage is the designation for places on this earth which have outstanding universal value to humanity. Universal value. Look at that term. And as such, they have been inscribed on the World Heritage List to be protected for future generation to appreciate and enjoy. Just now we have seen what is the heritage, the thing, the legacy from past. It has come to the present and it will be go to the future. So that legacy we have to maintain and we have to maintain nicely with all the values with it, because such places on the earth, they cannot be rebuilt. So what is our duty? We just have to maintain in their most beautiful condition or as it is. We cannot reconstruct those places. Prithvivar asha anek thekana ahe purna jagamadhe ki jala जागतिक वारसा लाभलेला आहे त्या दर्जाचे आहेत आणि ते भूतकाळात बनवलेले आहेत. काही गोष्टी आता बनवल्यात पण ह्या ज्या भूतकाळात बनवलेल्या गोष्टी आहेत आणि त्याला त्या अमूल्य आहेत. त्याची आपण किंमतच करू शकत नाही किंवा त्या पुन्हा आपण तशा बांधू शकत नाही. आता मी तुम्हाला काही पिक्चर्स दाखवणार आहे, मग तुम्हाला त्याचा अर्थ आणखीन जास्त चांगला कळेल. सो a World Heritage Site is a site determined by the United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization, that is UNESCO, to have significant cultural or natural importance to humanity. Now, what made those places to be preserved as World Heritage? So, for that, UNESCO, you know, there are so many organizations which work on the global level. So, UNESCO is one among them and it works for the educational and scientific as well as cultural function or cultural purpose. So, the UNESCO's World Heritage Site is doing this work of maintaining significant cultural and natural importance to humanity. युनेस्को ही जी संस्था आहे ती या जागतिक स्तरावर या ही जी काही स्थळ आहेत त्याचा दर्जा हा मानवाच्या दृष्टीने किती महत्त्वाचा आहे हे ठरवून ते मेंटेन करण्याचं काम करते. फॉर दिस पर्पज As such, the sites are protected and maintained by the International World Heritage Program, which is administered by the UNESCO's World Heritage Committee. So, there is one committee which is known as World Heritage Committee, and this committee is doing the work of maintaining all those sites throughout the world. UNESCO-chi World Heritage Committee navachi ek आणखीन उपसंस्था आहे आणि तिच्या मार्फत हे जागतिक दर्जाच्या वारशाचे जे काही ठिकाणं आहेत ती प्रिझर्व करण्याचं मेंटेन करण्याचं काम केलं जातं. बघा नीट लक्ष द्या, युनेस्कोच्या अंतर्गत वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज प्रोग्राम राबवला जातो आणि ते काम वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज कमिटी द्वारा केलं जातं. The meat of World Heritage Committee. आता या कमिटीचं काम कसं चालतं ते आपण बघणार आहोत. Because World Heritage Sites are places that are significant culturally and naturally, they vary in type and include forests, lakes, monuments, buildings, and cities. Now here you can see the pictures, different pictures are there. There are some places which comes in type of forest, so they have to preserve as forest. Some lakes are there. Some you can see monuments are there. Somewhere you can see infrastructure or building as Taj Mahal. And there are some cities which has been declared by the World Heritage Committee as the World Heritage Monuments. Okay. So under these World Heritage places, it is not hard and fast, or it is not typed that it should be only the building or it should be only the lakes, but different places on the earth, they have been included in this list. Okay. So World Heritage Sites can also be a combination of both cultural and natural area. आताच आपण बघितलं की वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज साइट्स मध्ये फॉरेस्ट येतात, लेक्स येतात, काही ठिकाणी मॉन्युमेंट्स आहेत, बिल्डिंग्स आहेत, तर काही वेळेला सांस्कृतिक आणि नैसर्गिक असं दोन्हीचं कॉम्बिनेशन असलेलं एखादं स्थळ हे सुद्धा या जागतिक वारशाच्या लिस्टमध्ये येऊ शकतं. ओके, फॉर एक्झाम्पल माउंट हुयांगशान इन चायना, यू कॅन सी देअर इज अ साईट विथ सिग्निफिकन्स टू ह्युमन कल्चर बिकॉज इट प्लेड अ रोल इन हिस्टॉरिकल चायनीज आर्ट अँड लिटरेचर. सो here you can see the picture of Mount Huangshan in China, and it has both types of importance, cultural as well as natural. It is a naturally formed mountain. Okay, you can see there, and it has cultural importance also because it has played a role in historical Chinese art and literature. So to more about it, to know more about it, you can visit the World Heritage site and find out more information about the Mount Huangshan in China. Okay, तुम्ही याच्याबद्दल आता मी जे जे काही जागतिक वारसाचे लिस्ट मध्ये वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज लिस्ट मध्ये जे काही स्थळं आलेली आहेत त्याची मी तुम्हाला थोडक्यात माहिती सांगणार आहे, कारण आपल्याला टाइमचं लिमिटेशन आहे आणि प्रत्येकाबद्दल डिटेल मध्ये मी तुम्हाला सांगत नाहीये. तर जे काही दाखवणार आहे तुम्ही सर्च करा आणि त्याच्याबद्दलची अधिक माहिती नक्की मिळवा. यू कॅन सी हियर द डिफरंट प्लेसेस ऑन दिस ग्लोब विच हॅज लिस्टेड इन वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज साइट्स. सो नाव फ्रॉम वेन अँड वेअर दिस वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज साइट हॅज टू प्लेस, कधीपासून हे वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज साईट बनवायची किंवा त्याचं कसं काम सुरू झालं, वी विल नो मोर अबाउट द हिस्ट्री ऑफ वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज साईट्स. याचं काम नक्की कसं सुरू झालं किंवा हे काम म्हणजे हे जे पृथ्वीवर ही जी वेगवेगळ्या देशांमध्ये ही जी ठिकाणं आहेत, जसं आपल्याकडे अजंठा एलोरा आहे, ताजमहाल आहे, किंवा आपलं CST स्टेशन आहे, किंवा जगामध्ये आपण बघतो चायनाची वॉल आहे, पिसाचा मनोरा आहे, मग यांना वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज साइट्स म्हणून डिक्लेअर का केलं गेलं, त्याच्या मागे कोणतं कारण आहे, वाय अँड हाऊ दिस कन्सेप्ट वॉज बॉर्न, वी विल नो मोर अबाउट इट. यू कॅन सी हिअर although the idea of protecting cultural and natural heritage sites around the world began in early 20th century, monuments for its actual creation was not until 1950s. Okay, then in 1954, you can see here in the picture, Egypt started plans to build the Aswan High Dam to collect and control water from the Nile River. As you know, Nile is the biggest river from the Egypt, and you can't deny that all the Egypt life is based upon the Nile. So they decided they have a plan. What plan they had? That they will build a very high dam at that Nile River and they'll collect the water from the Nile River so that they can use that water for many purposes, for agriculture, for creating electricity and all that. So the initial plan for the dam's construction would have flooded the valley containing the Abu Simbel temples and sources of ancient Egyptian artifacts. Now you can see there, I'll show you in the picture. See here, you can see. So there you can see the temple of Abu Simbel. Okay, you can see there are temples of Abu Simbel and at the bank of this Nile River. आता या नाईल रिव्हरवर जेव्हा आसवान धरण बांधायचं ठरलं तेव्हा त्यांचं असं लक्षात आलं की त्या नदीच्या काठाला अगदी प्राचीन अबू सिंबल्स मंदिरांची रांग आहे. आता जर हे धरण बांधलं गेलं असतं त्या धरणाचं पाण्याखाली ही एवढी प्राचीन दर्जाची मंदिरं बुडाली असती. मग आता व्हॉट दे हॅव डिसाइडेड टू प्रोटेक्ट द टेम्पल्स अँड आर्टिफॅक्ट्स. UNESCO launched an international campaign in 1959. In 1954, this project was started, and in 1959, UNESCO launched an international campaign to save this, and that called for the dismantling. You can see here, I'll show you the picture. So they planned to dismantle and move of these temples to the higher ground. So you can see here, the process of moving the temples required breaking them down into precious blocks and reassembling them pieces by pieces. So it was actually they wanted to protect it. They do not wanted to go it down under the dam water. So there was a thought that we will dismantle all these sculptures over here and we will reassemble it. And this UNESCO launched this international campaign. On international level, this work has been done, and the project cost an estimated $80 million. And because of the project success, you can see here, they are doing the work of Abu Simbel temples, and that campaign had revolutionized the international approach to safeguarding heritage. You can see here, जेव्हा ही कल्पना आली की हे मंदिर वाचवायचे तेव्हा तिकडच्या मूर्त्या तिकडून त्यांनी त्या डिसमेंटल केल्या आणि पुन्हा वरच्या हाय लेवलला नेऊन त्या पुन्हा रिअसेंबल केल्या आणि ही एक क्रांतिकारक घटना झाली. आणि याच्यातून तो थॉट आला की जे वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज आहे, जो जागतिक वारसाचे जे काही ठिकाण आहे, जी काही स्थळं आहेत, ती आपण अशी वेगवेगळे प्रोजेक्ट राबवून वाचवू शकतो. सो शॉर्टली देअर आफ्टर इन 1965 to protect the temples and artifacts, we have seen UNESCO launch an international campaign in 1959, and that called for the dismantling and movement of the temples to higher ground. We can see the work is done here, right? And then thereafter, in 1965, a White House conference in United States called for a World Heritage Trust to protect historic and cultural sites, but to also protect the world's significant natural and scenic sites. You can see here, in 1965, in US, there was a White House conference was held. You can see here in 1965, and what they decided, that they'll protect the world's historic and cultural site. 1965 ला US मध्ये एक व्हाइट हाऊस कॉन्फरन्स झाली आणि त्याच्यात हे ठरवण्यात आलं की जगातली ऐतिहासिक आणि सांस्कृतिक जी काही ठिकाणं आहेत ती आता अशा वेगवेगळ्या प्रोजेक्टच्या मार्फत सुरक्षितरित्या त्याचं जतन केलं जाईल. and then finally you can see here on November 16, 1972, a World Heritage Convention took place, and purpose was that to protect the world cultural and natural heritage. Okay, अशा प्रकारे वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज कमिटीची कन्सेप्ट जी आहे त्याचा जन्म झाला. कुठून झाला जन्म? इजिप्तच्या अबू सिंबेल टेम्पलच्या वाचवण्यातून वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज म्हणजे जागतिक सांस्कृतिक नैसर्गिक दर्जाची जी स्थळं आहेत त्या स्थळांचं जतन करण्यासाठी ती वाचवण्यासाठी काही करता येईल का या दृष्टीने जागतिक स्तरावर प्रयत्न सुरू झाले आणि युनेस्को टेक द इनिशिएटिव्ह फॉर दिस वर्क. अँड थ्रू दॅट कन्सेप्ट द वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज कमिटी वॉज फॉर्म्ड. And today the World Heritage Committee is the main group responsible for establishing which sites will be listed as a UNESCO World Heritage Site. आणि त्या संकल्पनेतून वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज कमिटीचा जन्म झाला आणि आज वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज कमिटी हे ठरवते की युनेस्कोची जी वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज लिस्ट आहे किंवा साईट आहे त्याच्यामध्ये कुठल्या स्थळांचा जागतिक वारसा स्थळ म्हणून समावेश केला जाईल किंवा त्याला दर्जा दिला जाईल. वी विल सी दॅट. नाउ देर आर सम नॉर्म्स दॅट विच साइट और विच मॉन्युमेंट्स और विच आर्किटेक्चर और विच प्लेस विल कम और विच इट विल इन्क्लूड इन वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज साइट. सो वी विल लर्न मोर अबाउट इट. देर आर 5 स्टेप्स okay for becoming a world heritage site. See, this is very important. You look and read it with me. Which are the first step? We will see one by one. The first of which is for a country or state party to take an inventory of its significant cultural and natural sites. This is called the tentative list. First step of becoming a World Heritage Site is that they prepare a tentative list, not final list. They prepare a tentative list. Okay. Then secondly, countries are then able to select sites from their tentative list to be included on a nomination file. Then country, those particular countries, they have to select which are the things they have been added in that tentative list. Then country will decide themselves that which site should be included in that nomination file. That liberty is given to that particular country. Then the third step is a review of the nomination file by two advisory bodies consisting of the International Council on Monuments and Sites and the World Conservation Union, who then makes recommendation to the World Heritage Committee. Now what is that? पहिली एक टेंटेटिव्ह लिस्ट बनवली जाते, नंतर त्या त्या देशांना ते स्वातंत्र्य दिलं जातं की त्या लिस्ट मध्ये जी ठिकाण आहेत त्याच्यामधली कोणती ठेवायची हे स्वातंत्र्य त्यांना दिलं जातं. ते झालं की नॉमिनेशन फाईल रेडी होते. देन थर्ड स्टेप इज दॅट रिव्ह्यू ऑफ द नॉमिनेशन फाईल इज डन बाय टू ऍडवायझरी बॉडीज. वन दॅट इज कन्सिस्टिंग ऑफ इंटरनॅशनल काउन्सिल ऑन मॉन्युमेंट्स अँड साईट्स अँड सेकंड वन इज द वर्ल्ड कन्झर्वेशन युनियन. तिकडे दोन समिती असतात, एक इंटरनॅशनल काउन्सिल ऑन मॉन्युमेंट्स अँड साईट्स ही एक कमिटी असते आणि दुसरी वर्ल्ड कन्झर्वेशन युनियन. त्यांच्या मार्फत या फाईल्सचा पुन्हा सगळा आढावा घेतला जातो अँड देन दे रेकमेंड टू द वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज कमिटी. त्यांच्या मार्फत मग रेकमेंडेशन शिफारस केली जाते. देन द नेक्स्ट स्टेप इज द वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज कमिटी मीट्स वन्स अ इयर टू रिव्ह्यू दीज recommendations and decide which sites will be added to the World Heritage List. So this work takes place only once in a year. So there is a World Heritage Committee meets and in that meeting they decide, they review all these things and then only they recommend and decide which sites will be added to the World Heritage List. Now in from India we have Taj Mahal, we have Ajanta Ellora Caves, so many places are there. So while adding those places in this World Heritage List, all these forms or all these norms or all these steps we have to follow. We followed, and then only those monuments or those sites have been added in the World Heritage Site List. Then the final step in becoming a World Heritage Site is determining whether or not a nominated site meets at least one of 10 selection criteria. So there are 10 selection criteria. So final step is that they determine whether, they decide whether or not a nominated site meets at least one of 10 selection criteria. There are 10 selection criteria which was decided by the World Heritage Committee. And when the site is being selected to add in this list, at least one among those 10, they have to be meet, or they have to see, or they have to fulfill those criteria. तिथे 10 क्रायटेरिया दिलेले असतात, त्याच्यातला कमीत कमी एक क्रायटेरिया तरी त्याला लागू पडला पाहिजे. इन दिस वे द बिकमिंग अ वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज साइट दॅट वर्क टेक्स प्लेस. वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज साइट मध्ये त्या लिस्ट मध्ये कशी त्या स्थळाची निवड केली जाते हे मी तुम्हाला इथे थोडक्यात सांगितलेलं आहे. Then we will see types of World Heritage Site. So there are different type of World Heritage Site. As we have seen earlier, some sites have cultural importance, some have natural importance, some have geographical importance. So there are different types of World Heritage Sites. So now in our book, as of 2009's information, in our book there are 890 World Heritage Sites. Okay. They have mentioned 890 World Heritage Sites in our course book, but here I am showing you the latest data. As per January 2020, there are a total of 1,121 sites, which UNESCO's World Heritage Sites in the world. Okay, if you refer the book on page number 77, you will find there is 2009's data, and in that data they have shown 890 World Heritage Sites, but it is latest data up to 2020 this year's, and some more places have been added in that list, that is 1,121 UNESCO's World Heritage Sites. Among those 1,121 sites, you can see a map with that. There are 869 cultural, 213 natural, and 39 are mixed, which have importance of cultural as well as natural, as we have seen a mountain from the China. Okay, then we'll move on. You can see here I have brought a map for you. This map is of types of World Heritage Sites, as we discussed just now. They have cultural as well as natural importance. So from Indian World Heritage Sites, we are very much versed with or well known, but we will see some other places on the earth. All, but I'll show you some places which are listed in the World Heritage Sites. This is Yellowstone from USA. See here, I have time limit. In limited time, I have to introduce all the points or all the important things from the World Heritage. But after watching this video, you rewatch it or you search on the net and you can find more information about these world famous places. So you can see Yellowstone and Grand Canyon National Park from USA. Such a beautiful place you can see here. Then 25 of the World Heritage Sites are considered mixed, that is natural and cultural. So we will see. So as we discuss, there are some sites which has mixed importance, that is natural and cultural. So this is one of the one among them, Peru's Machu Picchu. It is one among them. As I told you, you search on the net and find out more information about this beautiful place. We will see some more. So this is historic center of Vienna. This is Sydney's Opera House, very famous throughout the world. One more thing is very important in point of view of the World Heritage Sites, that Italy has the highest number of World Heritage Sites, that are 44. See, this is very important info, that Italy itself has the highest all among the world's heritage list. Italy itself has the highest places. There are 44 places. See, here I brought a map for you. I can't show you all 44 places, but here you can see Italy's UNESCO sites. And what about our country? So we proudly we can say that our country has 36 World Heritage Sites. Proud to be an Indian. So we have 36 among 36, 28 are cultural, 7 are natural, and 1 is mixed. So we will try to know more about our country, some of the sites. This is as per 2017's data. Among them, as you know, world famous Taj Mahal of Delhi or Agra, then Fatehpur Sikri, then Jantar Mantar, then we know there is a Kaziranga National Park, Manas Wildlife Sanctuary, Sundarbans from Assam, then Sun Temple from Konark. So many are there. So as I told you, I can't show in limited time all these places, or I can't describe you, but after watching this video, after learning this lesson, you can search on the net and find out more information about these sites. See here, UNESCO's World Heritage Sites in India. Okay. Now we will learn more about World Heritage Sites in danger. Why World Heritage Sites are in danger? Though UNESCO is trying its level best to save these monuments, to save these naturally, historical, geographical important places, but still World Heritage Sites are in danger. Why is it so? What are the reasons? Like many natural and historical cultural sites around the world are in danger or being destroyed or lost. There are some reasons. We will see some of the reasons. Among them, you can see here, due to natural disasters like earthquake or air pollution. We read frequently that Agra's Taj Mahal is changing its color because of the polluted air. There are some more reasons. Urbanization, uncontrolled urbanization. In India also, we have seen that though we have World Heritage Sites and around it, many people build their homes and houses and they stay, and they polluted, they pollute the air and water, and because of these historical sites, they are in danger or they are started destroying. And you can see here the tourist traffic, heavy tourist traffic. Many people are visiting to see those sites, and because of their pollution, these world famous World Heritage sites are in danger. So these are the some of the reasons. So when we learn, when we read about it, we feel so sad. So what can we do for preservation of this? We will see that. UNESCO is playing its role to save this, but as a human being, what can we do to preserve our legacy? So we will see some prevention, prevent ourselves and others from scribbling on the walls. As we see, when we visit to the fort, many people, they write their names or they carve it with some sharpened things. So prevent yourself also and other people also from scribbling on the walls. You have not built it, then you do not have any right to spoil it. Secondly, participating in the regular cleanliness drives. See, many times we see that some people, they participate in cleanliness drives on the force and all. Many young youth clubs are there, so people go there, these young children go there and they clean those forts. So you on willingly you can participate in this regular cleanliness drive. Then being a part of the Adopt Heritage initiative, you can being a part of this Adopt Heritage initiative. See, as we have seen that World Heritage Committee, they allocate resources from the World Heritage Fund to save that. Okay, but still this is our duty. In additionally, we can see that there are different plans put into the place to protect or to restore the site. So we can be a part of that. वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज कमिटी त्यांचं काम करतच असते. ह्या सगळ्या साइट्स क्लीन ठेवायला, त्या वाचवायला, त्याचं रिकन्स्ट्रक्शन म्हणता येणार नाही, पण जे काही ते वाचवायसाठी जे काही प्रयत्न करत असतात, तर ते करण्यासाठी जो फंड लागतो ते आहे त्या कंडिशनमध्ये ठेवायला, ते सगळं काम ते करत असतात. पण आपला पण त्याच्यामध्ये काहीतरी रोल असतो की नाही. सो वी कॅन बी अ पार्ट ऑफ द अडॉप्ट हेरिटेज इनिशिएटिव्ह. यू कॅन नो मोर अबाउट इट्स UNESCO's website. Then spreading awareness about these monuments and their importance. So after reading and after learning this lesson, now you are aware of the fact that how important those places are, and these places are never been rebuilt. आपण जे जसं आहे तसं पुन्हा कधीच बांधू शकणार नाही. मग आपली ड्युटी काय आहे? ते आहे त्या कंडिशन मध्ये प्रिझर्व करायचं. सो यू कॅन स्प्रेड अवेअरनेस अमंग द सोसायटी, अराउंड द पीपल, अबाउट सेविंग दीज मॉन्युमेंट्स अँड देअर इम्पॉर्टन्स. सो फॉर ऑल दीज पर्पज द वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज डे इज सेलिब्रेटेड every year on 18th of April to raise the awareness about the preserving human heritage, diversity and vulnerability of the world's built monuments and heritage sites. Also the efforts required to protect and conserve it and to draw attention towards it. To follow all these steps, to know, to spread awareness about all over this information, the World Heritage Day is celebrated every year on 18th of April. There are many reasons. First, we have seen to raise the awareness about the preservation. Then we have seen that it also efforts are required to protect and conserve it, because we cannot rebuild it. So it's our duty to protect and conserve it and to draw the attention towards it. Only one and two person cannot do that. But as a human being on this globe, it is everyone's duty to save these cultural wonders of the world. And for that, on every year UNESCO gives some program on this day, and throughout that year those programs they should follow by each and everyone, not only the World Heritage Committee. So now we will see. Now we are talking about the World Heritage Site, World Heritage Site. So here in short, I'll show you some World Heritage Sites from India, and you can search and know all those World Heritage Sites. Try to collect the information, you write it down, you draw it, and you try to visit it if possible in your future. So here are some places I brought it for you. Very famous Kaziranga National Park from Assam state. Then Manas Wildlife Sanctuary again from Assam. Then there is a Mahabodhi Temple Complex in Bihar, Bodhi Gaya. We have learned about it in history. And one more place, Humayun's Tomb from Delhi. Purposely I am not showing you the places from Maharashtra because you know about it. So you can collect more information about the rest of the places in India. And as we have discussed earlier, try to aware people around you. Now I know you have that sight or you have that eye that how important those places are and how should we conserve it. But you can spread the awareness among the society too. अच्छा भागामध्ये आपण वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज म्हणजे काय बघितलं, हेरिटेज या शब्दाचा अर्थ बघितला, वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज म्हणजे काय बघितलं, वर्ल्ड हेरिटेजची हिस्ट्री आपण बघितली, कुठून सुरू झालं, कमिटी कशी फॉर्म झाली, त्याच्यानंतर जागतिक वारसाच्या लिस्टमध्ये त्या स्थळांचा समावेश कसा केला जातो ह्याचे 5 स्टेप्स मी तुम्हाला सांगितले, आणि त्याच्यानंतर आपण बघितलं की वर्ल्ड हेरिटेज कमिटी जी आहे युनेस्कोची, ती ही जागतिक वारसा जागतिक दर्जाच्या वारसा स्थळांची प्रिझर्वेशन किंवा संरक्षण जतन करण्यासाठी कोणकोणते प्रयत्न करते आणि एक मानवतावाद किंवा एक माणूस म्हणून आपला त्याच्यामध्ये काय रोल असणार आहे. आपण फक्त स्वतःपुरता मर्यादित न राहता आपल्या समाजामध्ये आपल्या आजूबाजूला सुद्धा लोकांमध्ये हा अवेअरनेस तुम्ही क्रिएट केला पाहिजे की हे पुन्हा बांधणं शक्य नाही. आपण आपल्या महाराष्ट्रामधल्याच काही गड किल्ल्यांवर जातो तेव्हा तिकडची अवस्था बघून आपल्याला खूप वाईट वाटतं. तिकडे जे भेट देणारे जे पर्यटक असतात स्वतःची नावं लिहितात किंवा काहीतरी ड्रॉ करून ठेवतात. आता आपण ते ॲटलिस्ट आपण हे करू शकतो की आपण ते तिथे जाऊन पुसायचं, आपण ते करताना बघून आजूबाजूचे लोक प्रवचन देत बसायचं नाहीये, बिकॉज नो वन इज गोइंग टू लिसन टू यू, बट युअर ॲक्ट विल प्रवोक देम, युअर ॲक्ट विल मोटिवेट देम टू सेव्ह दिस or they will not do in their future wherever they will go and visit those places. Okay, at least that we can start from ourselves. आपल्यापासून सुरुवात करून तुम्ही ही जागतिक दर्जाची स्थळं वाचवण्याचा प्रयत्न करा and तुम्हाला जितकं पॉसिबल होईल भारतातली नंतर परदेशातल्या ह्या स्थळांना तुम्ही जरूर भेट द्या. आणि त्या काळामध्ये जेव्हा माणसाच्याकडे कोणत्याही मॉडर्न इक्विपमेंट्स नसताना लोकांनी ह्या इमारती कशा बांधल्या असतील किंवा त्याला ऐतिहासिक भौगोलिक महत्त्व का आहे या सगळ्याबद्दल जाणून घ्या.